So we are discussing about histograms. See, I told you, for discrete series we cannot draw a histogram. Okay, yes. Because I told you, see, in a bar diagram, these are not continuous. There is a gap in bar diagram. You see, bar diagram will be like this. There is a gap. But whereas in histogram, see, once higher, what you have high class value will become low, higher class limit will become lower class limit of the next class. So that is why there is no gap between bars. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Let's see, I will show you just one bar diagram. So this is basic bar diagram. No, you can see there is a gap. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, in bar diagrams, this is width, this is length, no? So width does not have that much importance in bar diagram. All will be of equal almost. But whereas in yes. case of a histogram, sometimes the width also will count. Okay? Width also will be important in some cases. Okay, so this is what histogram looks like. See, after constructing yes. lines like this, see, so on x-axis you will take one value, the frequency values you will take, on y-axis variables you will take. Okay,
yes.
So after the drawing of these lines is over, you know now how to draw these lines, you know now?
Yes.
Okay, now you see, here gap is given because from 0 to 10, this difference is there in values. That is a gap is given.
Yes.
Okay. Now again, after the drawing of this is over, the topmost one you pick. This is the topmost bar. Okay. So
yes.
you draw line like this to the next bar. Similarly, you draw line like to the next bar. Okay. You cross.
Okay.
This joining point is there, no? This will become
yes.
more of the frequency. This value will be more of the frequency, whatever it may be, 12. This
sir, why to draw that cross mark, sir?
In order to find out mode, that's all. If mode is not
okay.
the problem, you are not asked to find out mode, you need not draw line.
Okay.
Okay, only in order to find out mode, if in the problem it is given, you draw a polygon and histogram and you find out mode with that value, only then you will draw like that. Otherwise, you will not
okay.
draw. There is no need to draw. Okay.
Yes.
See, here they have drawn. The value is, see, mode is 80.6. This side you see. 80.6. It is between
yes.
78.5 to 84.5. Okay. Now you see.
Yes.
So, in multiple choice, they may give sometimes with the help of histogram, which of the following values can be found out? Mean, median, mode, like that they will give. Okay, mode
yes,
will
sir.
Be identified, mode will be found out. Okay, so daily
okay.
average page of this data is 80.6. Okay. Like that you have to mention if at all it is given. Okay, so same
yes, sir.
Same one. After this is our frequency polygon. See the difference, simple difference between this and that is, see what you are going to do is midpoints you are going to join, that will become frequency polygon. See this class midpoint is this, no, this class midpoint is this. All of them, if you join with the scale, that is frequency polygon.
Yes.
And you, with the help of scale, you have to draw. That will become frequency polygon. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So that is what they have shown here. You see, all exactly midpoints they have drawn with the help of a scale, not with ordinary hand, not with the free hand. With the scale, you have to draw.
Okay. Yes.
If you join with free hand without scale, it will become free hand curve without the use of the scale. If you join the midpoints, it will become free hand curve.
Okay.
The next one is, you can see. See, this is. Okay?
This yes.
A frequency curve. So it is a free hand curve, in other words. Okay? Freely you have, without the help of a scale, if you draw, it will become frequency curve. Okay? On a free hand, you are going to draw midpoints. You are going to join. Okay? The difference between the frequency polygon and the frequency curve is, in a frequency polygon, you are going to use scale. Here, free hand you are going to use. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to Ogive curve. See, before this, you have to know what is cumulative frequency. Do you have any idea about cumulative frequencies? See, table. This is the original data given. Okay, 0 to 20 marks for 6 students came, 20 to 40, 5 students came, 40 to 60 marks for 33 students came, 60 to 80 marks for 14 students came. This is the original data. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Now, cumulative frequency, this is frequency, no? Yeah. Cumulative frequency means, first one you will take right as it is. Second one, CF, you will call it also as CF, cumulative frequency. 6 plus 5 will become 11. 11 plus 33 will become 44. 44 plus 14 will become 58. 58 plus 6 will become 64. Like this. Did you understand?
Yes.
So that is a cumulative frequency. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is less than cumulative frequency. You have to remember it. Less than means from top you are going to add like that. If it is more than cumulative frequency means from bottom you are going to add like that. It means bottom means this. Six as it is you will write. 6 plus 14, 20. 20 plus 33, 53. 53 plus 5, 58. 58 plus 6, 64. Like this. Did you understand?
Yes, sir. Understood.
This is more than cumulative frequency curve. Frequency, that is.
Yes, sir.
Cumulative frequency. So, like this, see, always at the end you should get the total of this. Here also 64, here also 64.
Okay, sir.
Did you understand? If you made
yes,
it take in addition, your total will not be equal to this total. The end value okay. will be equal to this value. Okay, you should check it. So less than starts with starting one, more than starts with the ending one.
Okay? Yes.
So these are known as Ogive curves, Ogive frequencies. So now what you are going to do is, Ogive frequencies, if you plot on a graph paper, they will become Ogive curves. Did you understand? Yes, see, this is less than a frequency, no? So less than a frequency,
yes.
You are going to take on the x-axis, zero, with zero value you will start. Zero value means I will show you. See, from zero value you will draw line. So this is, zero value, no? Here it is zero value. So from zero value you will take its value, means I will show you. The starting value is 6, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can check. See, 0 to 10. The first class is 0 to 10. See this value.
Yes, sir.
Just a minute. Not 0 to 10. It is, you check it. 0 to 20, no?
It from, yes, sir. 0 to 20.
You will take 6. Value it as 6. 6 is the value that is given. Okay? Less than frequency curve. So, how you are going to draw yourself? 0 to 20. See here, value you are going to take 6. But starting point, you are going to start with 0. 0
yes.
At x-axis and y-axis joining point, you will start with this. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So like that. Similarly, after 6, next value is 11. So, exactly on 40, 11 will be there. You can check. Like that, you will go on drawing.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Come to this. What more than curve? See, more than curve. 80 to 100, no? So, 100 value you are going to take. Upper class limit. This will start with lower class limit. More than one, with 100 you will start to drawing. See?
Okay, sir.
I will see up to 100 you have drawn, you see here at the end you see,
yes.
100, whereas here lower class, first starting class lower limit you have taken, whereas in,
yes,
more
sir.
Upper class limit you have ended with, that you have to be there.
Yes.
Okay, now coming to this value, say similarly 0 to 20 starting value is 64. More than value, you see. 0 to 20, starting value is 64.
64.
So, 64, you are going to write on this, you see. With 0, you are going to start. So exactly 64.
Yes.
Okay, like this, for every value, you will go on like this. You will join up to higher class, upper class limit. You will end like this.
Yes, sir.
Starts with lower class limit, this ends with upper class limit. Okay? See, when you join, see, if both of more than class graph and less than curve also in a single diagram, you can draw. That is known as less than and more than ogive curve. Okay?
Yes, sir.
The joining point will become median. You have to remember it. With the help of
yes, sir.
You can identify median. Okay? That is important. Whereas,
yes,
in a frequency polygon, with the help of frequency polygon, with the help of this histogram, what you are able to find out? You are able to find more. Okay? Whereas, in case of ogive curves, it is median.
Median.
Fine. So, in multiple choice questions, they make you.
Okay. Yes,
that is important. Okay, so coming to the last one, is arithmetic line graph. See, normally, you know, arithmetic line graph is a time series graph. Time series means normally on x-axis you will show certain time. Time means, see, this is year. It may be year. It may be month. Okay, so
yes.
Production is regarding exports and imports, these values are. Okay, so on x-axis, you will you can see this is x-axis, no? This is y-axis. On x-axis, you have shown time. On y-axis, their values. One is representing export. So this line is import, is for imports, and this line is for exports. That is indicative. Okay? So, this is known as time series graph, line graph, arithmetic line graph. For time series,
yes,
you like this. Okay, time you will represent on x-axis and the variable you will represent on y-axis. So, that is arithmetic line graph.
Yes.
Did you understand?
Yes, sir, I understood.
These are the various graphs that are there for you. diagrams that are there for you. So this, what in this chapter, whatever exercises are there, we will do in the next class.
Okay.
If there are 3 or 4 problems are there with remaining on theory only, this theory question, multiple choice questions, or descriptive type questions. Okay.
Okay, sir.
The next class we will do problems, that are exercise problems. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.